There is another full moon approaching on June 17th. So imagine the next full moon standing right behind the top floor of the amazing Sky Tower in Auckland, New Zealand. Wouldn't it be amazing? What do you think? Is it possible? Will it happen? Let's figure out. Hello, PhotoPillers, Rafael the Bar here. Today, I'm gonna show you how to use PhotoPills to plan next full moon standing right behind the top floor of the Sky Tower in Auckland, New Zealand. And I want a really huge moon. After watching this video, you'll be able to plan any full moon shot you imagine involving a building as a subject. And you're able to do it to the very last detail, including the field of view and depth of field. I promise. And we start right now. New Zealand, what an amazing place. Amazing lighthouses, amazing wildlife, and lots of PhotoPillers. I had so much fun doing a workshop with PhotoPills master and friend Mark G back in 2017. I wanna go back. But let's go to Auckland now and focus our attention to our subject, Sky Tower. According to the official website, I'm leaving a link to the website in the description of this video, just right below. According to the official website, the Sky Tower is 328 meters tall. This is measured from the street level to the top of the antenna. And the top floor is located at 220 meters. Well, my goal here is to find a shooting spot and a shooting time where I can photograph the next full moon standing right behind the top floor at 220 meters above the street level. Are you ready? Because these are the 7 steps to plan the photo. Step 1. Place the red pin near your subject. Let's go to PhotoPills, tap on Planner. And as always, I'm planning my shot starting in Menorca. The red pin is in our beautiful island, Menorca. Now, to plan the shot, the first thing I need to do is to place the red pin near my subject. This is the Sky Tower in Auckland, New Zealand. To do it, just tap on Load and type on the search bar Sky Tower, Auckland. And now tap on the result. And here you have, the red pin has been placed right on the Sky Tower in Auckland, New Zealand. Cool! I'll move the red pin a little bit so you can see the tower a little bit better. Step 2. Set the full moon date. I'm planning the next full moon, so I need to set the date of the next full moon to see on the map where the moon will rise and set, so I can find my shooting spot. To do it, just double tap at the center of the time bar to set the date to today, to now. And then tap the moon picture you see on the top panel to move time forward to the next important moon phase. If I tap it, time jumps to the new moon. Tap it again, first quarter. Tap it again, full moon. And this happens on June 17th. If you know the date, you can also tap once at the center of the time bar and you can set the date using this screen. Step 3. Place the black pin where you want the moon to be. Swipe the top panel to the right until you get to the second panel, this one. Now, tap on the button you see on the panel and the black pin will appear on the map. And now, drag and drop it to where you want the moon to be. In this case, right at the center in the middle of the ground level of the Sky Tower. Step 4. Find the shooting spot and shooting time. Let's zoom out to have a better look of the area. Good. On one hand, just by looking at the map, I know that the moon will be rising in the direction of the thick light blue line you see on the map. And it will set in the direction of the thick dark blue line you see on the map. These lines will help me a lot to plan the shot. You'll see it in a minute. On the other hand, I want a big moon. The larger the better. Therefore, I need a large shooting distance. If I take as a reference the moonrise direction to plan the shot just right after moonrise, this faraway beach that you see at the other side of the bay looks promising. Let's try to find the shooting spot there. Let's zoom a bit on the beach and tap and hold on the place you wanna place the red pin. Now let's adjust a little bit the position of the red pin, making sure that the moonrise direction, the thick light blue line you see on the map, falls south from the black pin, from the sky tower. This way I'll make sure that when the moon rises, it goes behind the tower. So let's do it. I'll just place it a little bit more on the beach. Let's say like this, at least on the sand. And yeah, that's perfect. As you see, when the moon rises, it goes behind the sky tower, behind the black pin. That's pretty cool. Now, move time to align the moon with the black pin, with the sky tower, like this. Great, this happens at 5:22 p.m. Now, the top panel is telling me that the center of the moon is at 351.7 meters above the ground level, above the black pin. And that's a bit too much, because the top floor is at only 220 meters. So I'll move time backwards to adjust the altitude of the moon to 220 meters. Like this, 300. more or less, that's pretty cool. And this happens at 5:18 p.m. At this time, the moon is at the elevation I want. But if you check the alignment, you'll see that the moon is not aligned with the black pin. So I have to move the red pin to realign the moon with the tower, with the black pin. Let's do it. Go to the red pin, zoom in a little bit, and move it slowly. Say I'm gonna move it here and see what happens. If it's aligned or not. This is a bit tricky, but it's all about trial and error. In a few seconds, I'll get it. Let's try this spot. Almost got it. Last try. Let's say here. Okay, I got it. Now the moon is aligned with the black pin. But every time I move the red pin, the terrain might change, so the altitude changes. So I need to check again the elevation of the moon above the black pin. In this case, the top panel is telling me that the moon altitude is at 219.9 meters. So it hasn't changed that much. It's at the altitude I want, almost 220 meters above the street level. That's pretty cool. And the moon is aligned with the black pin, is aligned with the sky tower. So cool, I have my shooting spot and shooting time. If I go where the red pin is, this is my shooting spot, on June 17th, 2019, at 5:18 p.m., I'll be able to photograph the full moon aligned and centered with the top floor of the sky tower. But how big will the moon be? Step 5. Check the moon size. The top panel is telling me that the shooting distance is 10.9 kilometers. That's a pretty cool distance. Also, it's telling me the size of the moon I'll get for that shooting distance. This is 97.9 meters. That's a super huge moon. It's almost half of the tower. I love it. If you want to see the moon size on the map, just tap on the map settings button and now tap on the moon layer and switch on show moon size. Tap on done to go back to the map view, and here you have now the azimuth line on the moon is showing you the direction and also the size of the moon. So just by looking on the map, you can see how much of the tower will be covered by the moon, which is pretty big. It covers all the tower, much more than the width of the tower actually. Amazing. Step 6, check the natural light you'll have. Depending on the natural light you'll have at the time of the photo, you'll have one result or another. The moon can be faint if it's daytime, or can be really powerful when it's golden hour or blue hour. So let's check natural light. Swipe the top panel to the left until you get to the third panel, this one. And now pay attention to the elevation of the sun. The elevation of the sun gives you the type of natural light you'll have. In this case, the elevation of the sun is minus 1.26 degrees. This means that the sun is below the horizon and it's golden hour, so expect the moon to be pretty powerful. Step 7. Plan your field of view and depth of field. To plan the depth of field and field of view on the map, let's switch on the depth of field calculator. Just tap on the map settings button, and on map tools choose Dove, depth of field, and tap on done to go back to the map view. And here you can introduce the settings you want to use for your photo. For example, if I choose the Nikon Z6 as a camera, focal length 500mm, the aperture f8, I'll be focusing at the sky tower, so as focus distance I'll choose the black pin distance, to focus at the black pin distance. I'll be shooting in portrait, and as shooting direction, as framing direction, I'll choose align with the black pin. So I'll tap on align with the black pin, and as you see now the camera is framing the black pin, the sky tower. Notice that the hyperfocal distance is more or less 1K, and I'm focusing at more or less 11K where the sky tower is. So my focusing distance is larger than the hyperfocal. This means that I'll have my subject, the sky tower, in focus, and also the moon will be in focus. So it's awesome. And if I zoom in on the black pin, I'll see the field of view. Here you have it. These two gray lines are showing me the field of view I'll get, are showing me what will be included in the photo. Isn't it amazing? And that's it. This is how you can plan the next full moon with PhotoPills. I'll put a link to the plan I've just made in the description below, so you can import it onto PhotoPills. And if you wish to master depth of field, learn more about the hyperfocal distance, or learn how to photograph the moon, I'm also leaving the links to our depth of field guide and moon guide in the description below. Check them out. Now tell me, what problems do you have when photographing the moon? Comment below, I'm ready to help. And if you go and capture the photo I've just planned, please let me know, I wanna see it. I'm waiting for your comments. And as always, if you go to capture it, leave no trace. Let's take care of the planet. In the next video, I'm gonna plan another legendary shot, so don't miss it. Subscribe and click on the bells to get notified when we release it. See you in the next video. And remember that you have the power to imagine, plan, and shoot legendary photos. Bye.